Hi, it's Bill Dahlheimer for Pink Slip Mixers. I'm out here at the Clark County Shooters Park with Sue Lowden. She's running for a U.S. Senator. And I caught up with her to ask her how we're going to get jobs in Las Vegas.
There's two ways. And on my website, SueLowden.com, I spell it all out. And I would encourage anybody to go and look at the website. But I think that to create jobs throughout the country is what we need to do so that more folks come here and take vacations, have their conventions here. How do you do that? People have to have money in their pockets back in Connecticut, Delaware, and Michigan. And we have to start cutting taxes. I'm a big proponent of cutting the corporate tax, the payroll tax, and there's money in the employer's pocket and employee's pocket. And then they go out and spend money however they want. And it's a real stimulus thing if you have real money in their pocket. I would also remind folks that the 2001-2003 tax cuts are about to expire. The largest tax increase in the history of this country is about to happen next year unless I'm in the United States Senate. So I'm a big proponent of tax cuts. The other thing that I would do is take another look at welcome. I think we need to explore the possibilities there of recycling, renew processing. We talk about jobs for real jobs that can come right here with a new industry in our state. Not government jobs, but jobs from an industry that wants to come in. And frankly, that's what they do in Japan, and that's what they do in France. They recycle, and they're figuring out what to do with that so-called waste materials. And why wouldn't we be doing that here in Nevada? We've been building the roads, building the railroads to ship it in. It doesn't have to come from the South. It could come anywhere. We could decide that. We could get the research involved from UNLV and who we are. We could be a beacon of science and a beacon of research right here. So that's why I think the jobs are going to come from the future.
Well, plus we have over 3 million people in the economic economy for all these money.
Well, again, if you give the private sector the tools by making regulations and less burdensome from the company, if you give them tax breaks, you'd be surprised at how many people are going to start businesses, start manufacturing jobs. I think that's the greatest way as far as how you actually attract and you go out and improve that special servicing and visibility that we are attracting jobs because of how bad the economy is going to the entire panel. We all have these jobs that are coming here. Businesses that are moving here, and that's a very good thing. I remind folks that in the 90s, I was one of the architects of our workers' compensation law, which is one of those regulations that no one thinks about. But we have a really good workers' comp law here in Nevada, which helps employees and helps us grow here. We're not a bankrupt system like other states are in the world in New York in 36.0. And that really is a good bonus to the sections of the year. So I'm hoping that those who are responsible for that here in Nevada, our Lieutenant Governor, State Lieutenant Governor, and frankly, our county commissioners, the first thing on top of that, is going to make it out because we want to have an environment that they really are, they bring things to us. And then what I would do is recommend make sure they pass the regulations that they want to stay in Nevada and be
good luck for your event in the U.S. Senate.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for coming out today.
Thank you.